We're going to talk a little bit today about an advanced technique known as wrist block and wrist strike. Typically, when we practice this, we practice it together with a shifting of the stance. First, I'm going to explain a couple things about the wrist block and wrist strike, demonstrate each technique in its different form, and then put it together in the combination. So sometimes people might ask, like, why would I hit with the wrist? It seems kind of silly, and it seems kind of, dangerous. To that, I would say it is considered an advanced technique, and there is a certain amount of training and a certain feel for how to throw this technique in order for it to be effective. With a little bit of conditioning, you can, you know, you could use this technique for breaking. If you could use the technique for breaking, then depending on how many boards or bricks you can do, that would determine, you know, how hard you could hit and how much damage you can do to a target or a person. Now, the other question would be, why don't I just punch the guy? Why use my wrist at all? The wrist block and wrist strike has a few different uses that a punch doesn't have. Without having a partner here today, it's kind of difficult to explain that. But what I can tell you is one instance where you would use this technique and not a punch is if you have suffered a broken hand. You know, if you have damaged your knuckles or your metacarpals to where you can't make a fist or you can't flex and hit with your knife hand edge or your ridge hand edge or even using your fingers at all. Like if this hand, if I'm not able to use this in the way that I would normally use it, this is a way that I could still use this arm or this hand as a weapon and strike with. You know, of course we have elbows and things like that that we can use, but to hit with my elbows, I have to be at a little bit closer of a distance. So let's talk about the feeling of a wrist strike and block. I should have a flexing motion to it. It's not just a slap this way and a slap this way, and I'm not just clubbing like this. Although if you're good at that, you know, you can hit pretty hard. What I do is I have like this flexing motion of my wrist. I want to try and turn my arm and my wrist into almost like a mace or like a ball, a heavy ball on the end of a chain. So I need this whipping type of action. That's how I can best use this technique. So if I'm using it as a block, it's almost like a parry where I'm slapping a technique down, except I'm having this floating, dropping down action and this floating upward action, hitting with both sides of my wrist. So let's first talk about the technique as a block. I'm going to demonstrate this in a fighting stance, both downward wrist block and upward wrist block. Low wrist block, high wrist block. From the side. So that is using the wrist in a whipping type of action. that I could use as a block. Typically, when I would use this as a strike, I would like to be sideways facing to the target and rolling my wrist in this way, sliding my weight into the technique. All right, so coming forward with a wrist strike in a horseback stance. From the side, as a note, this technique can be done low, high, and then in, or it can be done high, low, and then in. Going to demonstrate that. Wrist block, wrist strike. Once again, from the other side. This has been wrist block, wrist strike.